spontaneous movement of substances from region of higher concentration to lower concentration. It plays an important role in gaseous exchange in cell. Okay. And next, osmosis. Osmosis is a type of diffusion. Here, the water molecules moves from higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. The semi-permeable membrane means the plasma membrane. Okay. So the movement of water molecules through a selectively permeable membrane from higher concentration to lower concentration. Okay. In previously discussed, when we discussed about diffusion, it was the gaseous exchange. Here the water moves into the cell and outside the cell by the process osmosis. Okay. In your textbook, an activity is given. It is asked what will happen if we put an animal cell or plant cell into a solution. A solution may be a sugar solution or salt solution. Okay. So there is chance. There are chance of three conditions. Three conditions may happen. And first one, hypotonic, isotonic, then hypertonic. So let us discuss about what happens to the animal cell or plant cell when it is, when we put it in a salt solution of sugar solution. See what happens when we put a plant cell or animal cell into a salt solution or sugar solution. Before that, you should know some terms, that is solute, solvent, solution. Okay. If we are going to make a salt solution, what is the solute there? Salt is the solute and solvent water. Okay. So solute plus solvent is solution. Okay. This is important that you must remember it. Okay. So let us see what happens if we put animal cell or a plant cell into a salt solution or sugar solution. Just think that there is a beaker. And it have water in it, and we are adding some amount of salt. And again we are adding water into it. That means it becomes dilute, isn't it? So the salt, the concentration of when the solution becomes dilute, that means the concentration of solvent is, or the concentration of water is high. Okay, the concentration of water is high. Then only we can say that solution is dilute. So in a dilute solution, first we are going to put animal cell in a dilute solution. What happens? So if this is the cell, the concentration of water is greater in medium, but the concentration of water is less in inside the cell. We put an animal cell in a dilute solution. What happens? The concentration of water molecules, water, is greater, higher in medium. becomes starts to swell. Okay, it becomes larger in size. This is very important. Once again, what is osmosis? Osmosis means the movement of substances from higher concentration to lower concentration. Movement of water molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. So here we have put a cell, animal cell or plant cell, into the dilute solution. Okay, in a dilute solution, the medium around the cell have higher concentration of water. They have higher water molecules. So as per the law of osmosis, generally the water from higher concentration, that means from medium to inside the cell, the water molecules moves. Okay. So it is very important. So what is hypotonic solution? What is hypotonic solution? Hypotonic solution means the medium in this having higher concentration of water than in the cell. And what happens? And water moves inside the cell. Inside the cell, and as part of that process, the cell increases its size. So, what is hypotonic solution? The medium having higher concentration of water than in the cell, and water moves inside the cell. Okay. And next is hypertonic solution. Hypertonic solution means, this is just opposite to the hypotonic solution. Hypertonic solution. Here we are taking concentrated solution. Concentrated solution. In hypotonic solution, we do diluted solution. Okay, here we are taking a concentrated solution. That means, what about the amount of water molecules in a concentrated solution? There is less molecules of water in a concentrated solution. The concentration of, in a concentrated solution, the concentration of solute is greater than the water molecules. Okay. The concentration of water molecules are less. Okay. So let us see. Again, we can take a beaker and we have prepared a concentrated solution of sugar or salt. Okay. So the solution is there, concentrated solution, and we are putting a cell. the water molecules from cell move outside the medium. This is the cell, and the concentration of water molecules is high inside the cell, and the medium have less amount of water molecules. As per the law of osmosis, from the cell, that means from the higher concentration of water molecules, it moves outside the cell. Okay, that means water molecules moves outside the cell. That means higher concentration to lower concentration. That is osmosis. Okay, and if we can take an example. As part of this, you have seen your mother making pickle. What she is doing at first, she prepares a salt solution and he put the mango, whatever it is, into the salt solution. Okay, and after some minutes, you can see the mango shrinks, isn't it? The structure of that mango shrinks, the shape. Okay, so like that, here when we put an animal cell into a concentrated solution, the water molecules moves from the cell to outside the cell. As part of it, as a result, the cell shrinks. Shrinks means that it decreases its size. Okay, but in the case of hypotonic solution, what we saw that the cell swells or it increases the size because the water gets inside the cell. But here it is hypertonic solution, the concentration of solute is higher, so the water moves from cell to the outside medium. Okay, so the cell shrinks. That means it decreases in size. So the making pickle, it's an example. So the example of hypotonic solution is when we put raisins in water. What happens after some time? It increases, it swells, and it increases its size. Okay, that is an example of hypotonic solution. Okay, so next, one more condition is there, that is isotonic solution. Okay, it is very easy. That means isotonic, the amount of water, the level of water molecules inside the cell and outside the cell is same. The solute and solvent, the concentration of solute and solvent is same. Okay, that we are putting an animal cell into the isotonic solution, what happens? There is no net drain, the net amount of or net movement of water into the cell and outside the cell. So there is no movement. That means in a cell and in the medium, the amount of the concentration of solute and solvent, that means, is same. Okay, so there is no higher concentration or lower concentration. So the water, the concentration of water in cell and outside the cell by the process osmosis is called hypotonic solution. So here you can see an animal cell RBC. So what happens if we put RBC into a hypotonic solution? What happens? The water gets inside the cell because the concentration of water molecule outside the cell is higher than inside the cell. So from higher concentration to lower concentration, the water molecules moves. Okay, so it is called hypotonic solution. Then next, isotonic solution. The medium having same water concentration as the cell, and there will be no net movement of water across the cell. Okay, such solution is called isotonic solution. Here you can see, we put an RBC cell into an isotonic solution. What happens? The concentration of water molecules are same inside the cell and outside the cell. So there is no net movement of water. It remains same. If there is movement, the amount of water moving out of the cell and moving inside the cell will be same. Okay. Then next, hypertonic solution. The medium having lower concentration of water than the cell, in which the cell will lose water by osmosis. The solution is called hypertonic solution. So if we put an RBC cell into a hypertonic solution, what happens? The water molecules moves outside the cell because the concentration of water molecules are higher inside the cell, so it moves outside. And we also discussed an example. What was the example? The making pickle. Okay. Then next we have a homework. How do substances like carbon dioxide and water moves in and out of the cell? That means it is asked about the gaseous exchange in cell. How does it take place? The gaseous exchange in cell takes place by the process diffusion. What is diffusion? The spontaneous movement of molecules, spontaneous movement of substances from higher concentration to lower concentration. So you have to define that. Then next, why is the plasma membrane called selectively permeable membrane? Why it is called selectively permeable membrane? Because it prevents the movement of some substances. It do not allows all substances move into the cell and outside the cell. So that is why the plasma membrane is called selectively permeable membrane. So next day we can discuss about the further cell organelles. So hope you understand. Thank you.